Don't gotta try again.
Don't look at me like that. Don't try to act like you ain't going crazy for me, baby, you can't. I'm fighting all my feelings, but it's hard to get you out of my head. And I should know that it's time to let you go. This could really hurt, but I don't care.
I could treat you right, girl, show you what you're missing. Looking in your eyes, I see nothing but nirvana. I would make you mine, but only only if you wanna.
I'm starting to question if leaving will lessen it. Breaking my heart, babe, a lesson I guess it is.
I found what your venom is, your lips are a death wish.
I wanna keep you around and show you what special is.
This could really hurt, but I don't care.
Thank you. Can't I just want to disturb your video for the views?
No.
This chapter is about recognizing the impact the union construction industry has on individuals. It highlights personal as well as union benefits. Mainly it's about you and how your family benefits. In the construction business, you're kind of in a business for yourself. Over 15 to 20 years, the way you work will determine your jobs, hours, and earnings. With a great attitude and top skills, you end up getting an extra couple hundred hours a year compared to an average worker over your whole career with a total hourly pay package of, say, $50 an hour. It adds up fast. If you figure 200 extra hours per year times $50 per hour times 30 years, that's a lot of extra cash in your pocket. Union construction still only has around 13% of the work nationwide. The union and the contractors are out there fighting to get a bigger piece of the pie. They're all talking to owners, developers, and builders about how it's worth paying top dollar for union construction because it's a better value. If the IUPAT trades do what needs to be done, IUPAT trades will have a couple of million union workers and contractors in North America, and that's an army to be reckoned with. What would it be like if we had 90% of the market and non-union workers had to get by on the other 10%? Who would benefit? Mm-mm. Chapter 3, Elite Warriors and Winners. In union construction, when I and others go out and meet with end users, public, private, the largest part of our presentation is that we represent men and women that are the best of the best. We don't say that you're good or that you're better or that you're average. We state that you are the best. Our quality is the best. Our performance on the job site is the best. We get jobs right the first time. That's what we advertise. It's so imperative that you become what we say you are. And if you apply yourself to the core curriculums and to the journeyman upgrading classes that we present on a monthly basis at the district councils and local union levels, and you will deliver on the promise that we make every day when we talk to these organizations, attempting to convince them to hire union contractors that employ union men and women. Set for you? How high is it set for your fellow workers on the job site? How many workers on the job are reaching that performance bar? How many in your union are reaching it? Being the best is not for everyone, and that's okay, but if they are not sure about the level of commitment that they are reaching, they should think long and hard about it. What you do every day affects every person on that job site that you're affiliated with. Every person. Every day. Every minute.
I have no idea.
Thank you.
How much tacos do you want?
Two.
Ten.
How much tacos do you even want?